Hey guys, my name is Jess and it is Friday. Here's the biggest things that happened in gaming this week, apart from No Man's Sky warping into your life. Tequila Works, the studio that made Deadlight, has been working on the ICO-esque Rhyme for a good 3 years now, and we've finally got some new info. Rhyme is described as a single-player puzzle-adventure game. Slated for a 2017 release, the alleged PS4 exclusive may not actually end up coming exclusively to the Sony platform after all. This week, Greybox and Sixfoot announced they would be helping Tequila Works publish Rhyme next year. These guys recently published the RTS, Grey Goo. Earlier this year, Tequila Works reacquired the rights to the game and parted ways with Sony, their publishing partner at the time. This week's press release indicated that gameplay and platform availability details will be shared early next year. Pokemon Go, oh yes, people are still playing that game, got an update this week, and here's what's changed. The nearby feature, which was kind of very broken, has been replaced by sightings. Sightings shows off Pokemon in the vicinity and aims to help aid in tracking the critters without revealing exact locations, as third-party services had been doing. The new feature looks like it will now show Pokemon that have appeared near a Pokestop. The patch notes also indicate that developer Niantic have made improvements to Pokemon catching, implemented bug fixes, and added a notification dialogue, reminding you not to try to catch Pokemon while you're driving if it detects you're going above a certain speed. Next up, a newly published Nintendo patent could be strongly hinting at what we can expect from the NX. Last month, a report suggested that the upcoming NX system would feature detachable controllers. And if this new patent is anything to go by, that could well be the case. NeoGAF uncovered the patent, which describes an accessory that can be attached to the outside of a so-called information processing device. The accompanying illustrations look an awful lot like a sort of controller that can be attached to the main device, but I'll let you be the judge of that one. The patent also mentions an infrared camera for the handheld device, which can determine what inputs on the accessory are being utilized. The NX is due out in March of next year. Nintendo isn't the only major publisher with a console on the way though, as it seems Sony have been getting pretty busy on the Neo front. According to reports by Gameblog and Vice, Sony are planning to officially unveil the more powerful PS4 Neo at an event in New York on September 7. Previous reports had suggested that the system could be released before the end of the year. Sony have indicated that the Neo is intended to sit alongside and complement the standard PS4, much like Microsoft are planning to do with the upcoming more powerful version of the Xbox One, codenamed Project Scorpio. Finally, there's been some confusion in No Man's Sky as two players meet up but can't actually see each other. After expressing some excitement that it was possible for players to find one another in the game, director Sean Murray hasn't really explained why players in the same location couldn't see each other. The Sad Cactus and Cytocat coordinated to meet, and although they could see the same world and each other's discoveries, they couldn't actually physically spot each other in their respective games. It's suspected that perhaps this is down to the fact that the game doesn't render a player model, server issues, or that each player exists in their own instance of the game, which are not shared with other players. This week on Site, we let you know how to get your hands on an Atlas Pass in No Man's Sky, talk about whether Titanfall 2 benefits from single player, and we eat Pokemon-themed donuts, because why the hell not? That is everything I have for you this week. Be sure to have yourselves a lovely weekend, and the Americans will be taking care of you next week, so I'll see you after that.